Hi everyone, this is Sharon, and today I'm going to show you how to insert a submit button on your PDF fillable form in Adobe Acrobat. Acrobat allows you to add different types of action buttons to your PDF forms, and we'll review the setup for adding a submit button to your PDF form. This interactive clickable action button allows users to electronically send their completed forms back to you through an email attachment. Let's take a look. We're going to add a submit button at the bottom of this form that was created in Microsoft Word. This is a job offer approval form template, and we're going to save this document as a PDF so that we can import it to create our fillable PDF form and insert our submit button down here. Let's go up to File, click on Save as Adobe PDF. Navigate to the folder where you want to save your PDF, name it, and click Save. Notice this opens our PDF in Adobe Acrobat. I'm going to go ahead and close this tab now. And I'm logged into my Adobe Acrobat desktop app, so I'm going to go ahead and click on Tools. And then I'm going to scroll down and click on Prepare Form. I'm going to leave Single File selected. I'm going to click on Select a File. I'm going to navigate where we just saved our PDF. I'm going to select our file and click Open. Our PDF will load right here, and notice that the form field auto detection is on. I'm going to click Start. Notice that the Prepare Form toolbar is now visible, and that form fields have been automatically placed into our form. Be sure and check out my other video on how to create fillable PDF forms in Acrobat to see how to edit, customize, and perfect your PDF form fields. Now let's go ahead and insert our Submit button. Let's scroll down on our document to the bottom where we want to place the submit button. I'm going to come up to the Prepare Form toolbar and I'm going to click on the button icon. An outline of a box will appear at your mouse cursor. Just move your mouse down to where you want to place the button on your form and click to place the button. We can name it here. We'll call it Submit Button. Then I'm going to click on All Properties. The button properties window opens, and here on the General tab, we can add a tooltip. Let's say we want to add click here to submit. Notice that you can also make certain form fields read-only or required. You can click on the Appearance tab, and here's where you can update the borders and colors or text of your form field. You can check the positioning, and then we have the Options tab. In the Options tab, we can pick a layout. When you drop down on the layout, you have an option to select only a label for the button, only an icon. An icon can be any sort of graphic file or image that you may want to have as your button. And you can also select different options to have a combination of both the label and icon in different locations. I'm just going to leave label only. You also have the option to change the behavior of the button. I'm going to select none to leave the default options of the button. Down here under label is where I'm going to type submit. This is the label that will appear on the button for your users. All right, now let's go to the Actions tab. Here's where you select a trigger for your action. I'm going to leave mouse up because that means that the button will be activated after a user clicks and releases their mouse. The next thing is to select an action. Drop down here and scroll down and choose Submit a Form and click Add. We're going to collect form data as attachments to email, so we're going to type mail to colon followed by the email address. Down here you can select your export options. I'm going to say the complete PDF document and then click OK. Now I'm going to click Close. Now let's go up and test our button. I'm going to click on Preview. And let's fill in some information here just for our test. I'm going to zoom out. Now let's scroll down and click Submit. You can use the default application as Microsoft Outlook or click on Use Webmail and then select and set up if you have Gmail or another webmail. I'm going to go ahead and leave the default setting as Microsoft Outlook and click Continue. Notice that Outlook automatically opened with an email ready to go to the address that we have programmed, and the completed form is being sent as an attachment. We'll click Send. Now we can come back and click on Edit. Now we can save our file. We'll go to File, Save As, choose our location, and click Save. Now your form is ready to send out. If you like this video, be sure and give it a thumbs up and share it. To see more helpful videos like this, be sure and subscribe to my channel and click the bell to receive a notification every time I post a new video. Be sure and visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com, and don't forget to visit the YouTube community post page on my channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.